好，大家好。我英文名字是Aaron，我中文名字是杰人，解去的杰，热闹的人。我今天要谈关于一些比较不一样的题目，不一样的主题。我今天不会讲关于就一个开源项目，或是也不会讲很多关于 Apache。 我今天要谈关于如何了许多不同的开源项目，来共同创造一个很棒的经验。这个经验就是英雄联盟。那我开始 为这个演讲做准备的时候，我真的想要用中文跟你们讲，可是呢，我中文不够，所以我必须用一些英文来跟你们讲，所以真的很抱歉啊。So for the rest of the talk, unfortunately, I will mostly use English.
所以接下来的演讲呢，很不幸，我们还是用英文。
So, what are we going to talk about? We are going to talk about League of Legends. We are going to talk about how open source makes League of Legends possible. And we are going to talk about the opportunity, what that means to all of us as opportunities in open source.
那我们今天要讲的呢，是围绕着英雄联盟这款游戏，我要谈三件事情。第一呢，什么是英雄联盟？第二呢，是开源带给英雄联盟什么样的可能？第三呢，英雄联盟这样一个开源的这样游戏开发，为我们揭示了什么样的机会？As
I mentioned, my name is Aaron. I am a member of the Apache Software Foundation. I've served on the board and on several projects. I previously lived in Hong Kong and Taiwan, spent a little time here in China. And these days, I'm in Los Angeles working with Riot Games.
那我还是来介绍一下我自己吧。那我的英文名字叫Aaron Farr, 我是ASF的成员，董事会的这个董事, 负责了ASF的几个项目。那我曾经在香港、台湾、大陆呢都居住工作过一段时间。目前呢，我是在洛杉矶 为Riot Games游戏公司工作。
Some of you may know Riot Games as the developer of League of Legends. Here in China, we cooperate with Tencent.
我估计大家对 Riot Game 游戏公司并不陌生，你们都知道呢，它是英雄联盟的开发商以及发行商，在大陆发行的合作伙伴是腾讯。Riot
Games has a mission to be the most player-focused game company in the world.
我认为呢，这个 Riot 这家游戏公司呢，是世界上最重视呢玩家的这样一个游戏公司。
And by that, I mean by the world, Riot is all around the world. We have 17 offices and over 1,700 employees. And we have an office in Hong Kong, and we are starting to put together an office for Shanghai.
那谈到我们这家游戏公司呢，可以说呢是一家全球性的，在全球17个地方设有办事处，目前员工数量是1700多家。那我们已经在香港有办公室了，目前正打算在上海也建立自己的办公室。And
to complete our mission to be player focused, we have a set of values about how we care about players and what kind of company and place we want to be.
那为了很好的完成自己的使命呢，我们有一系列的价值观，帮助我们呢更好的把玩家呢放在核心的位置。Those
we achieve this mission today through the game League of Legends. I want to know who has played 英雄联盟。玩过英雄联盟的，请举手。 So, some of you may not be familiar with it. League of Legends is very popular, even here in China. We have, right now, there will be millions of people playing League of Legends in China right now.
可能呢有在座的有一些呢对英雄联盟这款游戏不是非常的熟悉啊。其实呢它在全球的这个玩家数量是以百万来计的，那么在中国至少有几百万的玩家。
If you're not familiar with it, League of Legends is a team game with 5 members on each team. Each player has a champion or a hero that they play, and each champion or hero has abilities or powers in the game. The goal is to take over your opponent's base on a regular map.
那这个英雄联盟呢是一个团队作战的游戏，通常呢分成呢 AB 两个队，每一个队呢各有五名的这个成员，那这五名成员中呢会有一个领队或者叫做英雄式的这个人物，那这个人物呢他自然是具有超能力的，所以呢基本上来说呢在我们正常的这个游戏地图上呢，这个每一队的目标呢就是占领攻占敌方的这个大本营。
We also have lots of people who enjoy watching and playing League of Legends. This was in Seoul, Korea last year for our World Championship. And we right now are doing our World Championship in Europe this coming week.
其实呢不光是有人在玩这个游戏，还有很多的这个观众愿意看的玩家去玩这个游戏。这张照片呢显示的是去年在韩国的首尔，那么我们英雄联盟举办的世界级的这个锦标赛，在下周呢这个锦标赛呢就要来到欧洲站了。
And actually last year in Seoul we had a Chinese team, Starhorn Royal Club, that participated in the final World Championship.
那么在去年确实啊有中国的一个战队进入了最终的这个决赛，它叫做这个星角皇家俱乐部。
But perhaps it's a little better than explaining it. There's some things I can actually show. We could.
为大家放一段视频吧，给大家看一下。
One in each lane, obviously. You know, CC is her biggest weakness. Lock her down and make her a reset for Darius.That's the key to their team fight.
And we'll find out whether or not Fnatic want to once again camp for Huni, which has proved so successful. Will they be the first and only team to qualify for 3 World Championship semi-finals?
Bottom.
Huni is teleporting in for Koro. Flash comes out, followed by Yellow Star. And Fnatic should pick this one up real clean, real simple. And it's first blood.
And they, in such a short time, they also try and use the Vhagar Siege comp after seeing it here, but it didn't work out for them either. Fnatic burning this Baron down.
Well, they've got it before EG are even in range. And Yellowstar started to initiate. Horn is knocked up in the air so long he may as well have frequent flyer miles. Horn will try to rift walk away and get shut down. Reignover is out. It's a double for Reckless. He wants to run down more. Death, his brother in arms, will be his dead man in arms.That's a triple. Huni finds Clear Love in the back and Reckless with the rest of Fnatic. They're on to the Nexus and Fnatic will advance to the semi-finals. The only team to do that 3 times in the World Championships.
So this was in the quarterfinals about a week ago.It was one of the European teams and one of the last Chinese teams. I am sorry if you didn't know, but Edward Gaming's, the Chinese team, lost out to the Europeans.
那么刚才放的这段视频呢，是在上周举行的这个四分之一决赛。四分之一决赛当然很遗憾啊，我们的这个星角皇家俱乐部呢，还是惜败于这个欧洲的战队。
Now, that's what many of you see of League of Legends, or that's what most people see of League of Legends. What I'd like to talk about is a little bit what you don't see.
那么刚才大家看到的呢，都是在这个市面上大家非常熟悉的这个英雄联盟，但我们看到它的背后有什么是不为人知的呢？
This is a little bit, a peek, of some of the open source behind League of Legends. I started to...collect some numbers. For example, about 40% of all the servers that we use are running Linux.
那么这就是呢，在英雄联盟背后的大家看不见的开源的这个部分。 那么我为大家收集了一些数字，比如说呢，我们看到的超过40%的我们的这个服务器呢，运行的是 Linux。
When we build the League of Legends game client, we use over 40 different open source tools and libraries to make that happen. And in our main, one of our main back-end game servers, we also use over 30 Apache projects, just Apache projects, in that one server product.
那么当我们打造啊英雄联盟的这个游戏客户端的时候呢，我们使用了超过40个开源的工具还有库。那在我们的后台的这个主服务器的这个平台，那我们使用了超过了30个 Apache 的这个项目，我们指的是在英雄联盟的这样一个部分。
So what I'd like to do now is talk about when a player plays League of Legends, what open source do they use in each step?
下面呢，我就为大家介绍一下，作为一个玩家，那么你在玩英雄联盟的每一步的时候呢，那其实都使用了什么样的这个开源的力量
？When we start League of Legends, we have our patcher. Now in Tencent, here in China, we use actually a Tencent patcher, but in North America and Europe, we use this updater. And we recently rewrote a lot of it.To use Chromium, so the UI on it is uses Chromium.
那么大家都知道呢，我们必须呢有这个补丁程序。那么在中国呢，我们的补丁程序是由腾讯呢来去提供的。那么同时呢，我们目前啊这个阶段已经呢大量的这个重写了我们的这个补丁程序，目前用的是 Chromium.
Once you log in, you get to the Once that boots up, you get to our login. And our login uses a number of open standards. These include OAuth and OpenID Connect. And the servers that implement those standards are, use open source implementations of OAuth and OpenID.
Mm.那么首先第一步玩家的这个登录，在登录的时候呢，我们使用了开源的标准呢来做玩家身份的这样一个验证，我们使用的是 OAuth 还有 OpenID 的这样的一些方式。那也就是说呢，我们的这个登录的这个 login 的这个服务器呢，使得是这样一些开源的身份认证的这些标准。
We also have many websites where people log in, and we have started to use a lot of JavaScript frameworks to have reusable modules. Our login is one example of that, and the way we use those modules use open source projects such as Atomify and Browserify.
那么同时呢，我们当然也可以呢是通过网站呢来去登录。那么网站中呢，我们确实使用了很多的这样一些开源的这个 Java 脚本的这个框架。那其实我们呢一直以来呢都是强调，我们这些模块呢应该是可以呢重复利用的。所以呢，我们看当玩家呢通过网站登录的时候呢，我们使用的开源的是 Atomify 还有 Browserify。
Once you've logged in.We have our main client. We often call this the lobby client.
那么当我们这个登录之后呢，我们使用的呢是一个比较我们所轻量级的 link client. 我们用的是 lobby.
This is primarily written using Adobe Air, and we used one time a lot of the Apache Flex UI framework.
那同时呢，我们用的是 Adobe Firefox 加上呢，在 UI 方面用的是 Apache Flex。
We also use several small ActionScript libraries here, such as fzip for compression, exif for chat, and many small libraries for animation, such as TweenLite and TweenMax.
那么同时呢，我们还使用了很多其他的一些开源的工具，比如说呢，我们要做压缩的话用的是 fzip， 那同时我们要做呢游戏中的聊天呢用的是 xiff， 那当然还有一些的动画的这个部分，我们使用了 TweenLite 和 TweenMax。
Once you've logged in, you might want to go to the store. League of Legends is free to play.But many people choose to spend money to buy champions, unlock champions, or skins, other cosmetic content.
那么当然呢，在我们这个英雄联盟你来玩呢，本身呢它是免费的，但是呢我们也提供一些店内的这样一些消费的这种项目，比如说呢你可以购买了自己喜欢的这样一些领队或者英雄的这个人物，解锁释放他的一些能力，或者你也购买呢其他的一些我们说你可以换肤等等。
When we started, most of our web technology was written using PHP, and today the store is still primarily powered through PHP.
那我们一开始直到现在啊，我们的这个在应用的这个我们说游戏商店呢，都是用 PHP 编写的。
Once you've bought something in League of Legends, maybe you want to tell your friends about it, so you use our chat system.
那么在你呢英雄联盟你在玩，然后你做了一些消费，购买了一些非常酷的东西，然后你说我要使用呢游戏的聊天功能和朋友分享。
Our chat system is one of the most interesting uses of open source in League of Legends. Our chat system is based off the Erlang chat server called eJabberD. All of that is open source.
那么是我们的这个 chat 的这个系统啊，可以说呢是整个英雄联盟开源项目里头最有意思的这个一个。那么我们的这些聊天的这个服务器呢，是基于呢 eJabberD.
In fact, we've actually modified.Our eJabberD server quite a bit. I think it's an excellent example of how you can start with an open source software and modify it to what you need to do.
那其实呢，我们用这个 eJabberD 呢，对它呢进行大量的一些修改。这也展示了可能你一个项目一开始呢是基于开源的，但是反过来呢，你可以对这个开源的项目根据自己的这个需求呢做很大的这样一个修改。
So in addition to the XMPP interface that we have,for chat, we also have a web interface that we use through the web server called Cowboy. That's also an Erlang open source server.
那么事实上呢，我们呢有这个 XMPP 的这个接口，但同时呢，我们在这个 web 端呢，我们是使用 Cowboy 这样的一个 web 服务器。那么这个 Cowboy 呢，也是属于 Erlang 的这样一个开源的项目。
Each of our chat servers powers over 1 billion messages every day. And if you'd like to learn more about our chat servers, we have a number of articles on engineering.riotgames.com that go into this system in a lot more detail.
那么事实上呢，我们的这个聊天服务器每日呢支持的这个信息量呢，可以达到呢10亿条。如果大家呢对这个聊天服务器感兴趣的话呢，我们有专门的这个链接网站，你们可以获得很多的技术方面的文献。
Once you've decided to start playing a game, you'll begin what's called our matchmaking system. This is one of the most important servers and systems in League of Legends.
好，一旦你开始玩家开始游戏的时候呢，我们的系统会启动呢叫做配对的这样一个流程。配对的流程呢，我们是有专门的一个配对服务器来做，可以说呢，这是我们整个英雄联盟技术系统中最为重要的一个环节了。
Matchmaking, accounts, many of the systems that I've talked about are written in Java, and we use a lot of open source in all of our Java systems. These include examples like Apache HTTP.Components, Maven, Lombok, Google Guava. We also use Spring, Jetty, Jersey, Hibernate are very common open source projects that we use in almost every Java project that we have at Riot.
那么不管呢是我们的这个配对服务器也好，还是我们的这个账户的这个系统，我们都使用了大量的这样一些 Java 的开源项目。在这个片子上呢，我为大家列出了很多啊，像 Apache 的 HTTP Components、Maven、Lombok， 还有 Google 的这个 Guava、Spring Jetty、Jersey、Hibernate 等等。也就是说呢，你们可以看到，在整个的这个游戏系统中，凡是涉及到这个 Java 的这个部分，我们是大量采用开源项目的。
For matchmaking in particular, we make use of Hornet Queue, which is a message queue, and we use MySQL as one of our storage technologies.
那么在这个配对方面呢，我们呢在这个消息方面呢使用的是 Hornet Queue。那么在这个数据存储方面呢，我们使用的是 MySQL。
Now, once you've done matchmaking, you're going to start the game.If in matchmaking and on the Java side, we use a lot of open source, the most open source, it turns out that the game client has some of the least open source at Riot Games.
那么好，游戏开始了。我刚才为大家介绍了，凡是涉及 Java 的这个部分呢，其实我们用了大量的这个 Java 进行编写游戏的开发。那但是呢，我们看这个开源部分含量最少的，反而是在游戏客户端的部分。
That said, there is some open source inside the main game client, including Lua, Apache Thrift. We also use some small libraries such as zlib, curl, lz4. And to build the game, we use a lot of open source, such as Jenkins and FastBuild.
那么我们来看一下，在主的这个游戏客户端呢，我们主要的是用的 Lua, Thrift。那我们调用的这个库呢，有 zlib, lz4, curl1。那么在我们游戏开发的这个部环节呢，我们用的 Jenkins, FastBuild。
We also create a number of tools for game designers to make changes on League of Legends. Many of these tools use open source frameworks such as TK and Python.
那同时啊，我们也使用了大量的工具来供呢游戏的设计师呢进行游戏的这个修改，比如说 TK 加 Python。
When you're playing a game, a lot is happening on the network. A lot is happening in the back end.
当我们玩游戏的时候呢，网络端以及后台端呢，确实呢，这个在运行的东西非常多。
Within North America and Europe, we're actually building out a complete network in which, so that we can make sure that the packets go directly from the player to our servers in our data centers.
那么在北美啊，还有欧洲，我们呢正在建立自己完整的网络。这样的话呢，从游戏玩家这儿呢发出的数据包可以直接传送到我们自己数据中心的服务器上。
We use both private and public clouds to make this happen, and we leverage a lot of open source. One example is we use a fair bit of Netflix's open source software on our, in both our cloud and in our servers.
那在这里呢，我们借助了大量的私有云还有公有云的这样一些服务。那同时呢，我们在这个操作系统端呢，我们也使用了 Netflix 的很多的一些开源的这个项目来帮助我们做云的部分。
We've used Chef in the past for all of our deployments, and we're now experimenting a lot with Docker. I expect that within the next year, most of League of Legends will be deployed on the servers using Docker.
那么其实呢，我们以前的这个部署呢，用的不是 Docker， 但是以后啊，我们可能会在游戏的部署上大量的使用 Docker 了。
We also use Open Contrail as one example for our software-defined networking, and we're looking at a lot of the same technologies that were mentioned yesterday in Apache's Cloud Stack.
那么同时呢，在软件定义的网络方面呢，我们使用的是 Open Contrail。那同时啊，昨天呢，我们也谈到了大量的一些 Apache 这方面的这个新的这个技术，我们都会尝试使用。
Now, sometimes people like to watch you play League of Legends. Sometimes lots of people like to watch you play League of Legends. We have a system called the Spectator Grid that allows other people to watch you play the game.
那事实上有大量的一个人群，他们非常喜欢看别人来玩这个英雄联盟。因此啊，我们的这个游戏里头专门设了一个叫做观看这个叫做电子游戏赛的这样一个功能，我们把它称为 Spectator Esports。
Most of the spectator technology we have is again powered by Java in the back end, and all of the websites that we have for our esports.Are largely written in Node.js or use the Ember framework for front-end JavaScript.
那么其实呢，在这个后台的话呢，我们还是大量的使用 Java。那么在我们所说的网络前端的时候呢，也就是这个 Spectator Esports 的部分，我们是使用的这个 Node.js Ember.
To be able to serve as many people who want to spectate and watch or read about League of Legends, we use a large Varnish cache as well for our spectator grid.
那么因为啊，这样一些观看者的量非常之大，所以缓存肯定是要的，所以我们使用了 Varnish cache.
When you finish the game, we collect a lot of data, and this is one of the other areas where we use a lot of open source, is at the end of game. We have a very large big data warehouse, and most of that is powered with Apache Hive, Apache Spark, and we're starting to use Apache Kafka.
那么在玩家游戏结束的时候呢，我们已经收集大量的这样一些数据了。那我们有一个巨大的这个大数据的这个仓库。那主要的使用的是 Apache Hive Spark， 我们开始用 Kafka 了。We
also have some internal applications that use Elasticsearch to understand our data. And if you, my big data team told me that if you are interested in these technologies and you're interested in League of Legends, you should talk to us.
那么事实上呢，我们还有一些呢，就是内部的这个应用，比如说呢，做一些呢弹性的这个搜索。所以呢，大家如果啊，对我们的英雄联盟，对我们英雄联盟使用的这些开源的这个技术感兴趣的话呢，那你们当然应该和我们去接洽一下。Finally,
we also store a lot of data so that afterwards you can check how you did. This was a game where I actually won. So we have a match history system and many other websites that tell information about the game.
那事实上呢，在一个玩家结束游戏之后呢，你可以去查一下这个游戏的积分榜。那这个积分榜呢，是我们的这个 Aaron 是得了第一名啊。所以呢，我们有很多的这样一些就是游戏的这个数据可供你去查询。This
match history system is. We store the data in one of the world's largest React clusters.
那么可以说呢，我们呢是把所有的这些数据存在世界上可以说最大的一个 React 的这个集群上了。Again,
a lot of our web properties are built using very common open source stacks, using Java, Spring, Node.js. In this case, a lot of the data is also powered through Netflix's Zool proxy server.
那大家可以看到呢，我们在这里头呢是大量的这个网络的属性呢，都是用开源的这些技术来去编写的，比如说 Java Spring、 Node.js， 那么同时呢，我们还使用了这个 Netflix Zool.
Finally, sometimes players need help. So we have a number of systems to help with that. Most of our player support systems and internal applications are written using Groovy, Grails, or Node.js.
那么在这里呢，玩家在玩游戏的过程中呢，肯定要去需要一些帮助。所以在我们的这个帮助系统中呢，我们使用了一些内部的这个工具系统呢，是使用 Grail, Node.js 来编写的。
Our network operations center monitors what's happening in League of Legends all around the world 24/7. And they use a number of open source tools to do that, such as Zabbix, Graphite, Greylog, or Nagios.
那我们英雄联盟呢，在全球呢有网络运营中心，是我们的 NOC 是24/7的这样一个运行。那这个 NOC 呢，主要用了 Zabbix, Graphite, Greylog, Nagios 的这样一些开源的技术。
We go back.
Do you want to play a video?
Yeah.
这里头给大家放一段视频.
So this is all that I've talked about here is just a small portion of all the technology that goes into League of Legends. I tried counting all the open source projects that we had, and I stopped at about 100. Most of the technology that we use at Riot is built on open source. And I know that without open source, we could not have made League of Legends possible.
那其实呢，我们在做英雄联盟开发的时候，我一开始还在算呢，还在计数说我们用了第多少个开源项，开源的这个技术。但是当我数到100的时候，我就干脆不数了。我想说的是呢，英雄联盟如果没有开源的这样一些项目和技术的话，是达不到今天的成就的。
When we talk about open source technology, a lot of what we talk about is, to be honest, sometimes a little boring. But open source makes this. Open source makes some of the most amazing innovations we've seen in the last 10 or 20 years.
那其实呢，坦率的来说，那我们谈开源技术的时候，大部分的时候是挺单调、挺枯燥的。但是呢，借由呢开源的技术，我们可以打造这样非常有意思的这个游戏。而且我相信呢，在未来10到20年，最有意思的创新是来自于开源的。
And that brings me to the open source opportunities that we have.
所以我们就来谈一下开源方面我们拥有什么样的机遇。
I started this by talking about open source experiences. I use that word because open source is important by the change it makes in our lives.
那么我们来看一下，到底开源为我们带来了什么样的机会？我相信呢，开源为我们带来了改变生活、改变世界的机会。
Open source has created and transformed businesses, from Google to Baidu, from Amazon to Alibaba. Whether it's Microsoft or Intel, all of these companies have been transformed and sometimes even built by open source technologies.
我们看到有很多的这个企业公司呢，都为开源呢所改变。我们不管是说谷歌还是百度、亚马逊还是阿里巴巴，甚至微软、英特尔都加入了开源。
Open source is transforming education.
那开源呢，也在推动教育的转型。
My own education and career was largely created by what I learned through working with people like Brett and others at the open source, and Nicholas in particular back in the day, in open source projects.
那其实呢，我自己的这个事业还有得到的这个教育，主要呢是和像 Nicholas、David 这样的一些搞开源的人的这个身上去学到的。
Yesterday there was a topic about what does open source mean to students. And I want to emphasize again, I think open source is one of the most important things students can be involved in. When you get involved in an open source project, no one asks for your resume. No one asks for your test scores. They ask for your code. And you have just the same opportunity as anyone else despite their experience.
那昨天我们有一个专场啊，就是谈呢开源和学生的这样的一个关系。我想强调一下，如果你是个学生，你更应该呢做开源。为什么呢？你做开源项目，没有人会问你你的这个简历，问你要你的这个考试成绩，唯一要的就是把你的这个代码拿过来。
Open source also powers great entertainment, not only League of Legends, but for example, a lot of Netflix's technology.Is based on, is released as open source.
那其实呢，开源呢为我们带来了更多的这个娱乐的这个东西。不光是英雄联盟，其实呢 ，Netflix 啊也有很多的一些开源的这个技术。
Open source powers scientific discovery. A lot of what we've learned from scientific experiments, like the Large Hadron Collider by CERN, or what we see from JPL and their Mars missions.Most of that scientific learning is done through open source technology, like the open source big data projects we have, and Apache.
那其实呢，开源也在不断的去推动科学的这个探索和发现，比如说呢，我们经常谈到的粒子对撞机等等这样的一些科学的项目呢，也获得了像 Apache 这样的一些开源技术的推动。
Open source continues to innovate.Over the last decade, we've seen open source power the smartphone revolution. And what is it going to power next? We'll see virtual reality, we see self-driving cars, and open source will be part of all of that.
那我们看开源呢，也在不断的发展，推动更多的创新。智能手机呢，就是开源主导的这样一个创新的领域。我们还会看到呢，它会推动像虚拟现实、无人驾驶车等这样一些新的创新的发生。
What this gives us, what open source creates, is a sort of commons, a library, that all of us as engineers get a chance to use.This is our great legacy, and it's our engineering gift to the future.
那我认为呢，开源啊，就是为所有的这些大众的开发人员、工程师打造了一个公共图书馆。那这是我们共同的拥有的这样一个知识的这个宝库。那我相信呢，我们可是受益于这样的一个共同拥有的这个知识库。
But that future is not guaranteed.In order to continue having an open future, we have to participate, and that's largely what events like this are about.
那但是呢，我们要保留传承这样的一个对所有人开放的这个公共的这个知识库图书馆的话呢，这个东西不是说我们如果我们不每一个人站出来为他添砖加瓦做贡献的话呢，那这样的它的这个未来呢，并不说受到保障。
That's why the open source community is so important. It's As we say at Apache, it's people, it's community, more than it is code.
所以这就是为什么开源社区如此的重要。这也是为什么在 Apache 我们一直强调社区重于代码。
When I first visited mainland China in 2007, some of the first people I met were part of the Beijing Linux users group.
那我还记得呢，我是零七年啊，第一次来到中国大陆。那我在大陆见到的第一批人呢，就是在北京的这些 Linux 的用户。
The open source community that we can be a part of is a global community. It allows me to meet and have friends, colleagues, and people help me throughout the world.
那我认为开源啊是一个全球的大社区。那通过这个大社区呢，我可以在世界上结识各种各样的朋友、同事。
When you're part of the open source community, you're part of something bigger. When you're part of the open source community, you're helping me make League of Legends.
那么当你加入了这样的一个开源的这个社区，也就意味着你加入了一个更加广大的这个天地，也就意味着呢，你帮助像我这样的人呢，共同打造英雄联盟。
So my challenge to you today is to become part of that community. I'm excited to see you. I'm excited to be here with all of you. But I'm more excited to see the commitments and contributions that you'll make to other Apache projects or open source projects.
那所以呢，在这里呢，为大家发出的这样一个呼吁呢，就是一起加入我们这样一个开源的这个社区。那我今天当然很高兴啊，能够结识各位。但是呢，我希望呢，大家能够为我们的开源社区呢做出贡献。
So today, as you learn about other technologies, as you get to listen to experts in those technologies, don't just learn. Make plans on how you're going to be part of that process, be part of those projects, how you're going to contribute.
那么今天啊，我们会请来很多的技术的这些专家，为大家呢传授一些非常好的技术。但是我的要求就是说，你不要光在这儿去学习，你要做好准备。那么随时呢，也做出自己的一份贡献。
That way, next time we do this event, you'll have less white guys with bad Chinese you'll have to listen to.
我希望呢，下一次呢，我们再开这样的开源的这个大会的时候呢，那不会说中文的这个白人的数量能少一些。
So I want to thank you. I appreciate all of your time. For those that are interested in what we're doing at Riot Games, interested in the open source that we do, we are opening off. We have offices in Hong Kong and Shanghai, and I'd be happy to talk to you about those more.
那么，所以呢，非常感谢诸位的聆听啊！如果你们对开源、对我们 Rivet Games 公司呢感兴趣的话呢，那我们在香港和上海呢都有办事处，那欢迎大家来跟我们这个沟通。
好，谢谢你啊。
Aaron 请留步，来，我们要给 Aaron 赠送一份开源社的礼物，让我们再合影一张。
哦，好，谢谢。
Thank you, Aaron.
Thank you.
那么接下来呢，我们的一位keynote speaker 是 Nicholas Hedman。Nicholas Hedman 呢，他是 Apache 基金会 Zest 项目的 VP。那么除了他在 Apache 基金会内部的一些职务之外呢，大家都知道做开源的人其实是有很多张名片的。那么他是Code Dragons 的 CEO， 然后也是 Bali Automation 的 CEO， 然后呢他也是 Bright Things 的联合创始人。看到这么多 title， 是不是眼睛有点被亮瞎了？那么那个Nicholas Hedman 嘛，他是一位开源专家，他拥有非常高的开源水平。而且他也非常乐于的贡献社区。今天他的主题呢，是每一个开。